Hey boys, I'm back. It's been a while since I've recorded anything, but been wanting to put this video together for a little bit, so I figured I would take a few minutes before I got out of town, go back to Michigan on vacation for Christmas. This is going to be a little tour of my greatest accomplishment in the game so far in terms of the settlement building aspect of the game, which is something I feel is... It's pretty optional so far in the game, but it's something you could sink a lot of hours into if you wanted to. I know Schwinn was saying that a lot of people have done some pretty crazy stuff, and after looking at the system that they give you and the amount of parts and pieces and options, I can understand how that could be the case. A robot walking by is a basic, totally lame starter robot that I built. A little bit of ADD moment here, but we'll just go check it out. Got the Pimpbot 5000. Have not upgraded him or used him at all yet, but I want to get into that at some point. But anyway, I've got about 80 something hours in the game so far. Like I said, I'm combing the map more than just going straight after the main quest, which takes you right into the heart of the map. I didn't want to just bust right in there. And so doing this, I'll explore a lot of the map leading up to all the juicy parts of the main quest. And then I'll have my character leveled and equipped really well, which I already pretty much do. I've barely touched the main quest. I'm like level 23. And I'm suited out in like polymer combat armor and robot helmet and some unique items. Yes, there are unique items with unique properties. I guess there was some of that in Skyrim, right? But maybe just things with certain effects. I wanted to show you around my mission readiness center, or my mission ready center, it's kind of what I've been calling it to myself. And so I walk out my front door here, and we see this building here, which I had to construct out of the basic pieces that the game gives you. And there's various types of pieces that you can use, various categories. And there's several big foundation pieces here in the main town sanctuary. You're kind of your starting base, main home base, and this is there's some foundations you can clear the junky houses off of and build different things on. This is a settlement recruitment beacon, which sends out a radio signal which helps recruit settlers to each one of your settlements. And there's something like 10 settlements that you can work with. I really haven't done a lot of building beyond the minimum of providing people with food, water, and defense in each of the settlements. I do plan on neatening things up and extending out the capabilities in each settlement before I finish this game. Here's like a random settler here. It kind of randomizes them. You can talk to them. You can give them gear. You can make them equip gear and weapons and armor. I have set up a trade route between this settlement and another settlement I needed to build some things in, because what it'll do is it will make your stash of crafting components the same in both towns. Otherwise, you actually have to lug things between towns. That's lame. Supply line requires the local leader perk, so that's something you got to get with charisma. But if you look at what's in your workshop, you have a list of crafting components, and you can break all these things, get broken down to build different things, whether you're modding your weapons and armor or building out your settlement amenities and building it physically, like the buildings. So what I had to do to establish that trade route is I had to obviously get the perk, and then also I had to assign one of my settlers to be a trade caravan operator, and they'll actually go back and forth between the between the settlements that you link them, and as you link up this network, your stash becomes the same, or everything becomes accessible, and all the settlements reachable by the caravan that you've placed. And you see here on the Pip Boy, you can hit C to show supply lines. So you can see I have a supply line going between Sanctuary and Abernathy Farm, and shows the number of people living there, the happiness level, etc. So let's take a look at my building here. I did it sort of with the barn / warehouse category of building options, and so I tried to build it about as big as I could on the foundation that I had. And there is some, you can't really remove some of the environment stuff, so there's some plants coming up through where I extended the foundation. And I actually, if you hold down the workshop button, you can see here that I did extend the foundation with each one of these blocks. And these are kind of the main size of pieces that you're typically working with for the large stuff anyway. So you have to go through here and place everything in, set everything in place. And it has a good auto snap system, but it still can be kind of finicky. Kind of tricky to line everything up, especially if you've got something that won't snap and you want to get something aligned straight in relative to something else. And I'll show you some of that inside. I actually could pick up this entire building as one unit and move it. It would be kind of a huge disaster, and it would, all the items inside that weren't like constructed would flop and fall over the place, and who knows what, maybe disappear. But so I did do a little bit here with the electrical system. So we've got this rolling door here. I just kind of wanted to give the image of sort of a barn type, warehouse type building here with some high security area inside it that I could store some valuable items, weapons and stuff. So if we look at, I guess also around the back, we got a Brahmin walking through town. The lighting is just absolutely incredible. It's just a sight to behold. Once again, 4K Ultra. It's utterly beautiful. So we got some dynamic lighting falling on the buildings, and you can see how that building casts a shadow dynamically on my building that I built, so it's not just completely static. I think this is a water purifier. That's a medium generator with a water pump, provides water to the town. I got to figure out a way to move some of these electrical, move some of the generators around. You can install conduits and make it look really tight and clean and have the generators out of the way. But for right now, since I'm still, in progress of building this thing, I just have this generator sitting here. But I experimented a little bit with some of the switching and some of the power distribution. So when you hit the switch, it rolls up the door, it turns on the neon lights, and it also opens this interior door. Now the structure I have in here is sort of, I built a, there's sort of a, I guess you would call it a mezzanine around the concrete and steel intersection, and I decided to make that intersection like my high security area where I can keep all my weapons and power armor and ammunition, like you see there. I'll show you in there in a second. And then I built it up. You see, you have a wire there, but I could get this out of the way with just using conduit. And then downstairs, right in here, for quick access, I have some crafting stations. Got my armor workbench. I got a trunk here to hold some armor pieces. Weapons workbench. I go to this one a lot because I'm modding out my weapons a ton. And I've got like, okay, I like to name my weapons. This 44 revolver is Dirty Harry. I've got Kyle's Legend, which is like an almost maxed out sniper rifle, in reference to famed Navy SEAL sniper Chris Kyle of American Sniper fame. Pretty sick, large scope, muzzle brake. Let's see, I'm losing my ability. There we go. I'm having a hard time rotating it. The high damage, what do I got on there? The medium quick eject magazine, the powerful receiver. So this is great for taking down feral ghouls when you're outside of town. Got this Mr. Handy Buzz Blade, which is basically a circular saw blade from a Mr. Handy on the end of a, like a weed whacker something, haven't upgraded this much yet. Got a Power Fist, I just picked this up. Classic Fallout melee weapon. Have not upgraded or tried that much yet either. Relentless Authority, Righteous Authority is one of my go-to weapons. It's an automatic laser rifle. You see I've got this rotating automatic barrel. Let's see, does it let me? Yeah, it's going to let me. A little finicky on the rotation. Got this rotating automatic barrel, a reflex sight on there, a recoil compensating stock. So this is really high damage. And you can actually modify special weapons. You see right here this effect. It says critical shots do double damage and the critical meter fills 15% faster. You can modify even unique weapons that you find. You can see the kind of laser flowing through there, and this rotates and shoots automatic. When you make a weapon automatic, you usually give it significantly less damage, but higher rate of fire. This thing will tear guys up pretty good. This 45 submachine gun I have right now, called Silent But Deadly, that's a ridiculously high damage weapon I've made out of a special Thompson submachine gun I found. They explode. The bullets, the base effect is exploding bullets on impact and doing 15 points of area effect damage. That's in addition to the powerful receiver, the recoil compensating stock, the large quick eject drum, and the silencer I've put on it. So, I mean, you can mow through crowds of super mutants pretty good with this thing. I'm stoked about that. Got a plasma pistol. Haven't played around with that a lot yet. I have a very simple syringer rifle. It's like you can craft and launch syringes full of chemicals that have different effects on enemies, like poisoning them, draining their health, making them explode and mutate, or explode and spawn a bloat fly when they die. Like, I think, I don't know if that bloat fly fights for you, but I call this a Drugonator. Haven't done much to it. It's pretty ghetto. Street Sweeper is my automatic combat shotgun with drum magazine. Got a bayonet on there. It's really just a big Bowie knife with strapped onto the stock there. Got the Synth Slayer. Synths are the, like I said before, the robots that are in the game. There's various stages of them that are various forms of development of the synth technology. Some of them are just creepy mannequin robots, and others look a lot like humans. This 10mm submachine gun or machine pistol is, I've tricked out with a large mag, you know, hardened piercing auto receiver, reflex sight, silencer, great for tearing up synths. Okay, so we'll exit the station here. Right here I keep some power armor parts. I have some lockers right here I installed just to keep some extra parts. I kind of group things by category. Got some melee weapons in here, some weapons I'm not really using right now, or things I've used previously I don't really need to carry, and then some weapon parts. When you upgrade a weapon, the parts that come off of it go into your inventory, and they weigh about a half a pound a piece a lot of the time, so it's good to stash those away unless you want to use them. So I keep them in there. And we got a wooden crate there for miscellany, and we got a chemistry station here. You can make different drugs and needles for your syringer. You can make grenades, different healing packs for yourself and for robots that are with you. I find it really funny that the robot repair kit is basically like a set of batteries. I'll go in my inventory and show you this. The robot repair kit is basically a syringe with batteries instead of a thing to hold liquid. Let's look at this. Right. So it's like, what, you're shooting the robot up with batteries, I guess, to heal it. So I haven't tried that yet, but so if we go inside the main room here, you can see my suits of power armor that I've collected. You can have multiple suits. You kind of just find them through the wasteland and or the Commonwealth. And so yeah, this entire room and ceiling, floor, all the weapon racks, everything I've had to build out, the lighting. I have a sort of a dual-layered floor and the ceiling and the floor for the next level that allows electrical conduit to run through there, so I can power some of the lights that I got going here and not have any ugly wires. There's also wireless power emitters that allow you to get a little bit of range on your electrical devices without having wires going straight to them. We see dog meat has climbed up on top of that missile launcher. That's pretty bugged. That's pretty funny. He likes to do that. Here, I think I can command him to get me a weapon. Check this out.
Hey. How you doing, buddy? Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me?
Actually, that's finding specific things. Maybe I just command him. So we go. Hey. We command him, and then we point at it says, get this double barrel shotgun. Right. I just find it very amusing to see him with. With a double barrel shotgun in his mouth. And then I can put that back up there by taking it, going over to the weapon rack, and transferring. And I think it's a short double barrel shotgun. I have so much stuff in my inventory at this point. Is it just a double barrel shotgun? We can sort by weight. Well, no, we can't sort in this menu. Got a bunch of extra weapon parts in there, like I was telling you not to do. Two shot. There we go. Just put that in there, and then it goes in the rack. So, these suits of power armor, you can upgrade them with different parts, different paint schemes. You see some of, a couple of these are kind of incomplete, like this set of Raider armor. We'll send
hey.
Dog meat out into the middle
Head
of town.
Over there.
So he'll gets out of our way.
Heads up. Go there.
There we go. Hopefully he stays there. And I have this power armor workstation, which you use to craft, repair. You need steel to repair your power armor. I usually, up to this point, have only used power armor really for, when I know I'm going into the shit or really difficult encounters, when you really need that extra armor and the ability to carry heavy weapons, really heavy weapons, like the missile launcher, the Fat Man, which is the mini nuke launcher, which just creates like 100-foot-tall... Oh, and he's back. Creates just like a real dog, annoyingly getting underfoot all the time. And you can see also that I've equipped him with actual dog armor. Not a $2 DLC pack, unlike Oblivion's horse armor. But this will create a gigantic mushroom cloud, the Fat Man. There's not a lot of ammo for it, but I use it against hordes of super mutants or hordes of robots, or when you're really getting overwhelmed by stuff. You got the minigun here. You got these heavy weapon stands that'll they automatically adjust to the length of the weapon you're putting on there. And then I have some, what I got? So I got some long guns here, and you got sort of like a bar looking weapon. I named it the Ba because we're in the northeast. Liberator is like the first laser musket you get. The old brain pan aerator, old sniper rifle I had before I built Kyle's Legend. Got a 50 caliber bolt action pipe rifle. I want to get some more of my weapons up to 50 cal, but you got to have a lot of gunsmithing, a lot of gun nut perks, and high levels to get up to be able to build recon scopes. Recon scopes track targets on your map once you acquire them, kind of like Far Cry or other games like that. So over here we have an Institute rifle. I named the N7 Shepherd because I felt it looked a lot like something out of Mass Effect. That's upgraded pretty good, but I've been using Righteous Authority, that other laser rifle I showed you. So, and over here, some of the stuff I just put in here for flavor. I built a little weapons workbench table here. I got a tool chest, toolbox. Got some weapons laying around here just to look good and show what the area is supposed to be for, and So I've got like this, I put this neat light here. That's this two-piece thing. It's under the desk, kind of curved it over the desk. I thought that was pretty cool. It looks pretty cool in here at night when everything is just kind of lit up. But right now it's kind of daytime. Here's an ammo table. Just got an ammo box here. Some of the different, tried to put out an example of most of the ammo types in the game. 5mm for the chain gun, flares, 5.56. I haven't been able to make a weapon or find a weapon that uses 5.56 yet, but I have a lot of it. Railway spikes. There's a railway rifle that shoots railroad spikes. You can nail people to the wall, like the old game Fear, First Encounter Assault Recon, which I loved greatly and finished in 3 days. But I've not found that or been able to build it yet either. So Dog Meat's cocking his head and looking longingly at my Institute pistol and 10mm pistol. So that's pretty much what I got going on in here. Now if we go upstairs, we find sort of the... this is more sort of a armor storage slash goodie storage type of area. Another big area that I can build out with whatever I want to do in here. I've got a couple display cases to show some of the collectibles type things I've found on a preserved cigarette pack, which is like a perfect, you know, new condition pack of cigarettes. There's a unrusted tin can. There's a few items in the game you can find that are not taken by the apocalypse. A clean globe. There's Vault-Tec lunch boxes. These are all over the place. And when you open them up, it kind of does a little flare and shoots little fireworks and little streamers out of there and pops open just a random item, I think. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it sucks. And close this. I think you can also build these display cases with lights in them, which would be kind of cool. This locker holds robot pieces, which I have not built any robots other than the basic robot. It is raining right now, which is raining through. For some reason, it believes that these ceiling pieces are the broken ceiling pieces or something, and so it allows it to rain through there, which is kind of lame, but whatever. Oh yeah, I do have a missing piece of floor here because I haven't fully installed all the conduits here for the generators to power all the lighting down there. I probably have more generators than I need, but this is the robot crafting station. Once again, have not worked much with that, but I plan to do that and work on the old pimp bot a little bit. This is my armor storage area, so I got some. This dresser holds armor mods, some different pieces of armor and clothing I might want to hang on to. Got a postman hat in there, sunglasses, all kinds of different stuff, and then you can build these dummies that you can equip with whatever sets of armor and accessories and glasses and helmets that you want. I got a baseball uniform here. I just thought that was cool. I put it on there. And it's the same type of thing. You just use the armor rack. This guy's wearing my vault suit and my old red flight helmet and my polymer armor combat armor chest piece. So you can kind of display sets of armor you want to use. I'm going to make this probably more complicated or a little better organized or build out some other buildings, but right now this is kind of just my catch-all. And store some different food that you can plant in this box. All your settlements need food, and so you can't just obviously plant a bag of potato chips or plant a box of Fancy Lad snack cakes, but you can plant these plants. And you can give your settlements food. These coolers have standard food. I got one for standard food. You don't want to end up carrying all this stuff around with you. It weighs a lot. So you want to just kind of keep a stash. And as you cook stuff, it gives different effects and different properties to you. So maybe you can pull out a Deathclaw steak. It gives a really good boost in HP and gives you some stats. Got my drink cooler, all my extra Nuka-Colas. Beer, alcohol is very important because it helps you carry more, it gives you more strength. I am drinking alcohol and popping pills almost nonstop in this game, which is evidenced by the addicted to alcohol and addicted to pills icons in the lower right hand corner. I'm addicted to Buff Out. Buff Out gives you strength and endurance, and it's great for making other drug cocktails that give you other effects. It's great as a base drug, and I pop it so often that that I'm just permanently addicted to it. And you can go to a doctor and get de-addicted, or you can purchase extremely expensive Addictol, which is a drug that ironically gets you unaddicted. But I keep drugs in here. I could run my own operation. I've got 42 syringes or inhalers full of Jet. I haven't used a lot of the extreme drugs, even though they have really cool effects like slowing time and giving you crazy damage and things like that. But I mainly just stick to Radaway and Stimpax, a little Med-X to prevent damage, Rad-X to prevent radiation if you know you're going in a high Geiger counter clicky area. And then the rest of it here is just kind of display cases with stuff that I've found. I've got this, check this out, I got this sloth toy. Thought that was funny since Brad Thor is the sloth. Found a couple models of Mr. Handy, a Sentry Bot model, got a bowling pin, liquor decanter. It'd be cool to make a liquor cabinet actually dedicated. I've kind of piled up some of these lunch boxes. It's neat because in order to place things, they've made it a lot easier than the previous games. You can hold down F or hold down your use key to pick something up. And then you can click the left and right mouse button to rotate it on an axis. But then you can hit shift and it will start rotating on another axis. And you can hit shift again and rotate it on all three axes. So it makes it somewhat easier to arrange your stuff. And then you just kind of hit F to drop it. And then it falls over and is a disaster. But we can just do this. Oh, did it again. There we go. That's better than nothing. Got some magazines in here. These magazines, of course, as previously in Fallout 3, give you different stat boosts and skill boosts. So I've just kind of piled up, kind of organized some of them in there. I thought this camera's kind of cool. Pro Snap cameras, Switchblade, some more magazines. You can see the neon signs kind of blinking through the rusted holes in the building. Got a Deathclaw hand from a Deathclaw. Look at the size of that, that I nuked with a mini nuke when I was exploring a sinkhole. Got an American flag. I was trying to find a non-broken one, but I'm not sure there's one in there. Or I'm not sure there's one available in the game. And then this holds all the recordings and notes and such that I found. They don't weigh anything, but it's kind of nice to get those things out of to stop crowding up your inventory. So, in the corner is a steel ball that I made with my manufacturing system, which I'm just starting to toy around with. I think you can make some extremely complicated sets of, like, machines that can manufacture items for you and run them along conveyor belts, deposit them in containers and such. You hook up this terminal here. I put a lit cigarette there just to... because I thought it'd be cool to have a cigarette next to the computer. But you go into this terminal and you can run this builder. I don't think I have it. So you've got different things you can build. And I think I don't know if this is based on. Okay, so you need three steel to build this lunchbox. So I don't know if this is based on the kind of builder you have. I think there might be multiple kinds of builders. I think I built the miscellaneous builder. So it says you need three steel. So I think I haven't used this in a while. I was going to play around with it more. I think what you got to do is you got to put it in the hopper. You got to put the component in the hopper. I may not have three steel on me. I may have to go to my... I don't think I do. So here's what we'll do. We will go downstairs to the workshop, grab some steel, and or something with steel. You can have the raw material, or you can have something that just has it. So I got the 21 steel. Just grab three here. I wonder if that lunchbox has has a random item in it, like it does when you find it in the wild. I'm hoping it does. So, transfer. Roll the mouse wheel, even though when you unlock it, it does the weird thing that Ben said it does. So you put the three steel in there. Then we go to the terminal. And I think you can automate the loading and the unloading of your builders. Schlocket Industries. So, your launch box. Okay. So we clicked it. Now we'll see. I think this thing is going to start cranking. Unless I don't have it hooked up to power, we'll see. Oh, there it goes. And the launch box comes out and is unceremoniously deposited on the floor. Now we'll see if we get the goods out of it. Nope, it's just a launch box. Well, that kind of sucks. Yeah, there's a lot of interesting things you can do with that. So this pretty much concludes the tour of the current state of my Mission Ready Center. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I kind of spend time in here between missions, going out on the road, exploring, and so just thought it was kind of cool to have a base of operations. Notice here that you can't have the American flag flying lower than any other flag. Got the Minutemen flag there. So that is that. We will shut this up, shut this down. Hope you guys have a Merry Christmas, and we'll hopefully we will game, talk to you guys and game with you soon. Peace. Brad Thor out.